have something to do today, so I will be streaming this right now. I tried repairing the disc and I've gotten some success with it. I've managed to fix a few things, but there's a scratch on it that makes it impossible to where I just cannot get the credits to play. Unfortunately. It is way too bright in here. I remember when I tried to play Thief Deadly Shadows. During the day, it was completely pointless. Especially if you're trying to play on the CRT, and the CRT has any hint of There we are. If you're trying to play on the CRT, then it is all you're going to see is your own reflection. I just want to put the terrible things I saw back there behind me. I am not going back. It's probably smart. Everything else apparently works, and apparently the only thing that is damaged on the disc is just the credit sequence, which is unfortunate. If I ever do have to resell this, I'll have to add that. I'll have to point that out. But everything else seems to play just fine. I'm not sure. I haven't gone through all the cutscenes. But when I tried to verify the disc, it went up to 97%, so I'm fairly sure. And I've buffed out most of the surface damage, and there wasn't really that much, except that there was one really bad scratch that caught my nail when I ran my nail against it. I'll do more research on it. The problem is that the tool that I'm using it doesn't really quite. I'm not sure if this is the problem, but it doesn't go all the way towards the it doesn't go to all the way towards the edge of the disc. And there's a couple of bad scratches. Not really bad, but just noticeable enough. Can I kneel? You're okay, Fiona. It's just a very large amount of blood. There is one item here that I was never able to get, and I don't know what to do about it. Formula and computations have been scribbled on the desktop. This goes beyond something that you learned at the college level. Luminescence. Yeah, those are those annoying things that pop up and make a lot of noise. I think I'm pickier with the condition of my items than other people are, so if it runs just fine, I don't think anybody would have a problem buying it. I wouldn't feel good about not being truthful about it. Scary doll you have there. Teaches you how to hide. What's odd is that there's no other way to view the credits except finishing the game, so unless you finish, you wouldn't really know. There are also other... I've noticed that I found some other ways that you can do it. You can actually get a buffer, just like a regular buffer that you would use for buffing your car. Just a motorized one, and if you apply the correct head to it, there's the appropriate heads available there, and just apply some solution, like I've been using an eyeglass cleaner. Since I've run out of the resurfacing here, which I'm pretty sure was just eyeglass polish as well. And honestly, the eyeglass polish seems to work much better. All I have is a brain and swift feet. Nothing unusual. We have to hide this blood. So it says MF, and when we look at this poor creation, and this is what puzzles me, is that there's all this refining equipment, and this is the only place that looks like a laboratory, but it's we can't use it yet. Or rather, we can't use it. We have to go find a hole in the wall. Anyway, from our initial playthrough, we realized that we are looking for a... We actually want to use, try to use meth instead, because that's the name of another villain. And I don't actually know what happens, but... And I did kind of cheat to find that out. This is a bird cage. It looks like the remaining husk of a bird in the cage. When I first saw this, I first thought that
it has alphabetic keys.
This is where how you save the game, like in the Resident Evil 4. But no, that is not the case. And of course, I stupidly typed my, That's not what I wanted to do. It's like a toaster. A really creaky, grindy toaster. We take that with us. Hopefully Debilitas is not, Debilitas is still outside somewhere. Reaction time. We got a special item. Choker composed of long slices of durable obsidian. Obsidian is not durable. It's really sharp though, and easy to cut, which is why it was so popular. So it's really sharp, but will shatter if you drop it. Reduces the strength of Azoth odor emitted from Fiona. Player can more easily escape being detected by luminescence. Now we have access here. Understood how to get that how to get that item. I think I'll check later, but I think you can use an explosive. This bench has been situated so it's facing the wall. No one can sit in this. Actually a fun place to hide.
See you finally awaken. There's something that I've wanted to show you for quite some time. Pull away that sheet behind you. In the future. Go ahead. You may touch it. You will be mine, Fiona.
Well, there's your answer, Fiona. Nobody here is in their right mind. So large and bulky, it's hard to imagine people play these things. I've seen them play it. Just apply enough force, I might be able to knock it over. Oh, almost forgot the key. If you play, since this is not our first time playing through, we know that's Ricardo being a freak. Gate is closed, there's no way through, I'm going to have to find another way. I actually do find another way, but it is fairly far into the future. means that feverishly pursue Fiona once they cause wound of her, luminescent causes makes contact with Fiona. State of panic, but produces noise. Yeah, it says there's a hook, but I didn't realize that you don't really see a hook. I thought you needed the rope or something, but yeah, you do need something else to stick in that weird puppet-shaped hole up top. Actually, I do need to see one more thing before I get out of here. It's the first out of two times when you release a bunch of roaches into the castle, and I'm sure everybody is going to be happy that you're doing that. For some reason, this door is held with a key lock. Basement. Yeah, it's totally disgusting here. The map. So now we have a map. And it did mention that a part of the castle is in red, and that is the chapel where you ultimately fight to be with us. Oh, so you can break these pots. This is the last place where you can actually break them. To dirty her outfit by climbing under the table in this disgusting basement. It's called a wine cellar, but there's really no wine down there.
Ah! I am Ricardo, keeper of the castle. So sorry to hear about your accident. Your parents. As Master Ugo and Mistress Ayla are both deceased, you, Miss Fiona, are the sole surviving heir of Belly Castle. Are you in pain, miss? Will you be all right? You've had a long day. Please, rest upstairs. Your bed has been prepared.
Time to help our buddy. Digging deeply into his neck. Stop petting him and take it off.
Go now, and don't get caught this time.
So poor animal, and that man, so big and freaky. I just want to get out of this nightmare as soon as I can. Probably nothing. Let's go back to our room. Waiting for you.
Oh.
That is the last time it will be that effective.
Thank you. You saved me. Come here. Come on, boy. What's your name? Hewie? So you're Hewie. Well, hi, Hewie.
Wounded, the game is over. If your dog has taken a lot of damage, be sure to avoid fighting as much as possible, or heal him with jerky and other recovery type items. It's a little bit more difficult to control, apparently.
Good boy. Hewie. Hewie.
I'm not sure if this is the case, but I've heard that
go, Hewie.
The more you play with them, and that's not what I wanted you to do. It's okay.
Go, Hewie.
Just interact with him in general. The more responsive he becomes. I did sort of notice that, but I think that was just me getting more used to the controls as time went on. I never got the ball to work properly.
Hewie.
That boy disappear.
Come on.
I heard him somewhere. I think he went outside and got stuck. Nope, you're right there. You're just kind of derpy.
Hewie. Come on. Come on. Sit. Good boy. Go, Hewie.
Honestly, this is the majority of my experience with German Shepherds.
Hewie.
They're very capable creatures. They will fiercely defend you, they will fiercely defend the house. Very intelligent. Quite capable of hard work, many number of roles. But they will only do that if they really want to.
Go, Hewie.
Come here. I have to tell you, you're a good boy.
Hewie.
I feel so bad the number of times I accidentally kicked Hewie in my first playthrough. It's broken marionette. Its strings have been cut in various places, rendering the puppet unusable. Has been shut and locked solidly. It would be impossible to open it without a key. That's the main objective you have in this game, is finding that key and...
Hewie!
It's quite an objective. It locks from the other side.
Hewie!
Come on, buddy. Stuff to do. I almost forgot, I think there's some items in here.
Hewie. Go, Hewie. Come on. Come on. Come on.
One that usually, if you make steady progress, he does seem to be more inclined to follow
you. Come on.
We have to print some more plates.
Come on.
I think there's a special plate for hard mode that you can print out. They definitely intended for you to replay this through hard, and they did it. They gave you plenty of Alchemist, but I can't remember how they wanted you to spell it. There we go, this is how you spell it. But we can't really use it anyway because we have to find a hole in the wall.
Come on.
Little bit stubborn boy. Once again, very accurate of what the German Shepherd is like in real life. Oh, I forgot one more. There's one more that we have to do. Sure, this is it. To remember if I unlocked this. Probably didn't. Yeah, it's still locked. It's okay. Hewie, I don't think you can follow me here. Walk away from them. Walk by this mess that I made. Best time to strike up a conversation with this weird woman. Perfect time to make a mess and lead a stray animal through the kitchen, though. And yeah, the other part of the broken key is ST, so REST, rest. I miss my fairy earrings already.
Hewie.
It's okay, leave that woman alone.
Come on. Come on.
First place he looks, actually. I have no idea what these are. Just random storage. It took me a ridiculously long time to figure out this puzzle. I'm not sure if I actually figured it out. I think I did check a walkthrough. But yeah, you're supposed to hang this, that's the hook, apparently. And I don't understand why I didn't piece together broken marionettes with, someone trying to scare me off. But yeah, I don't know why I didn't piece together marionettes with a puppet room. Small iron sticks. This place is so freakish. So yeah, that's Hewie trying to tell you not to be stupid.
is this?
You must pay attention now, Fiona. Be wary of Ricardo. Your Azoth.
Hello? Hello? Are you there?
I originally thought he said my darling, but he apparently says my dolly. It's actually a it was only a matter of time. It was not the right place to run. That's why I saved. That's why we always save.
Come on.
I'll check later.
Hewie.
Hard to say how he knew I was there. get in the bathtub.
My little pink meatball.
I may have to switch to normal Hewie because why I thought it was about to get me. Because the tan and black German Shepherd is far more aggressive. He seems to be performing well for now. I'm just a little bit afraid that he'll jump into combat when he shouldn't. And get badly hurt, and I'll get the game over.
Come on!
Forgot where I was supposed to go now. The door I just opened. Maybe right there. The line must have been cut, there is no dial tone. There's nothing out of the ordinary here. Magnesia. Oh, you're not supposed to be here yet.
Go!
Good job, Hewie. Sure, there's gonna be more little surprises like that in the difference between hard and normal difficulty. Pretty sure I saw the same tile scheme in Thief the Dark Project. Say this about dogs in general. They are I'm not gonna say they're disloyal, but if you give them something like jerky or chicken, they will love
Hewie.
You.
Hewie.
I did deal with a dog once that just that would like to pretend like he wasn't having it, but then as soon as you were out of eyesight, he would start chewing on it.
Hewie. Hewie.
Hewie. thing has, Hewie. But... Hewie, I really need you here. What's this? This crest, why is it slanted like this? Is there a doll in a cage? Maybe someone is trying to keep one of their valuables and they're locking keys, and again, maybe not. It's a box, but I can't open it. Yes, you can. Oh, I thought there was only one item. Silver earrings designed after Ouroboros slightly increases the speed at which you calm down in a panic. That's good. Jade choker. A choker or jade green like a tropical ocean reduces the speed at which stamina is lost, increases recovery speed. Also increases chance to avoid enemy power attacks.
Hewie.
That's not what I meant. For a small child, the sheets have become discolored from lack of use. I guess the maid hasn't tended this room in a long time. Day. It's like it's the title of this diorama. Section of handrail seems to be gone. They always say never look down in the movies. I think I will follow their advice. And pops crackle this dubious looking hole. Everything and about the hole screams didn't go in. Enter the hole? Yes, actually. Something written here. I just noticed that there is indeed a slot machine right here. This machine before, there's a slot in it. More equipment. Platinum earrings from the shape of an ankh. Recovery from a state of panic much faster than usual. Additionally, your panic to a lesser degree when hit. What do these do? Oh, well, these are much easier to use. It's gonna make the game much easier.
Hewie,
where did you go? Where could you have gone? Thank you. going to go down just yet. Instead, I'm gonna trigger this cutscene that I forgot about. Yeah, I'm sure nobody heard that, Fiona. It is from the family of Clock Tower games, but I'm also playing on hard, so it is more aggressive, but it's a very fun game. I'm actually trying to find the hiding spot.
My little piggy pie.
And I lost my dog, which is great. Oh, here he is. Hi, Buzzy.
Go!
My God!
Chewie!
Fiona! Fiona!
There is actually a way to hurt him. There we are. I miss my fairy earrings from the original playthrough last night.
Chewie!
Oh no, 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 no. Oh, shoot, I locked my dog out. Get over here. I don't want to deal with you. Get out. Screw it, I'll hide somewhere else.
Come on. Come on.
It's my darling.
It's a luminescent, it doesn't hurt you, not directly. What it does is it causes you to It follows you around, and if it hits you, it explodes and causes you to panic. And when you're panicking, you can't use equipment, you can't use, and you're stumbling around like a dumbass. It basically makes things a lot more difficult. I think I'm about to switch back to albino or white Hewie, because white Hewie is a lot less aggressive and easier to control, although a black and tan Hewie is more aggressive, and I think he has a higher hit points, but he's more obstinate. He's like a real German Shepherd. It's a really fun game. If you want a physical copy, you're gonna have to drop a lot of money, especially if you have the if you want the American version. Normal mode, where you don't have to really worry as much about Hewie's health, because if he falls to critical in this game, in hard mode, then it's game over, while in normal, you can pretty much just, you can pretty much just run off, like this, and just let him fend for himself. This was the wrong door. I'm gonna hide under Daniela's bed. But yeah, this is a fun game, but the mechanics are kind of weird, and the rules for the mechanics kind of change throughout the game. Like, they still work the same, but they're used under different circumstances. And if you want to laugh, look at last night's video and watch me constantly screw up the last 3 minutes of the game. There's also a side game for a mini game after you complete through the normal version, where you are Hewie and you lead Fiona through areas, and I honestly wish that they like, you have to lead her through an area while avoiding a stalker, and I wish they implemented that in the main game, where you could switch to Hewie and scout ahead. Another thing about keeping Hewie around, it's much better to keep Hewie around because the game lies to you, because when it tells you that the coast is clear, the coast is most definitely not clear. So you have, Hewie doesn't lie. If he's growling, that means something bad is nearby. I don't think he's aware of this hiding spot yet, so he's not looking under the bed. Yeah, see, Hewie on... when he's brown, black and tan, he's a lot more aggressive. Also, if the music comes back to normal, that's how else you can tell that, see, right? I'm pretty sure it's alright right now. Stamina, both of you, and the way you recover it is by tussling his ears or giving him beef jerky or something like that. You also get a bunch of equipment like magnesia and antimony, both of which explode. Magnesia has a very has a very, very specific hitbox. Landscape painting composed entirely of the color red seems quite out of place when compared to the other items in the castle. Not when you go further in. The magnesia is hit or miss. It's basically a landmine. The antimony which you throw is much... I found it much more difficult to throw, and I haven't figured out how to use it effectively. You also find a ball that you can play catch with Hewie, but neither the AI nor the game seem to be very cooperative when it comes to that. It's a good game, but it has a lot of quirks.
Hewie.
Stepped and walked all day. Yeah, I don't like stuff made out of fur either. I mean, if it's scrap leather from the beef industry, like if I want to do something, make some, I don't know, replica medieval armor or something, I'll use scrap leather that I buy from Michael's or whatever. Because otherwise it's gonna go into the trash. But I wouldn't buy anything new. Probably wondering why I locked him out. Actually, he knows exactly why. A door? It's just a wall that's made to look like a door. Also made purely just to screw with you. The price for this game went absolutely crazy in the past several years. I remember back in 2012 I wanted to get this game. It caught my attention. I saw it on eBay for like $50-$60 and I thought that was pretty high. But
Hewie.
I want to get that item. But right now it's like $300, $400, $500.
Come on.
Was a couple of months ago like $400. Now I regularly see it for $900.
Go, Hewie.
And yeah, you can use them to do things like this. Yeah, and the copy that I have right now, the copy is almost perfect. I mean, I saw it had a few scratches, but I didn't really care because I was glad that I had a copy that worked. And I was gonna make an ISO of it, but it was actually in a lot worse shape than I thought, and it had several deep gouges. I resurfaced it and got most of them out. But whenever I try to verify the disc, it gets to 97%, and then the verification fails. So I can't even make an ISO of it, unfortunately. I'm gonna keep trying to repair it, but for now it seems to work. It actually works a lot better after buffing it. And the only place it doesn't work is during the credit sequence. It gets stuck during the middle of the credit sequence. Oh, you found something.
Good boy.
There are two reasons to tell him he's good boy. Number one, he listens to you more often. Number two, your friendship with him increases, and your friendship with him determines your what ending you get.
Come on.
Thank you. there's a breeze coming from the other side that bleeds. We'll find out later. There's actually a puzzle here. Stuff, we're gonna open this so that we can access the other side of the castle. Yes, pull the lever, why wouldn't you? I'm gonna cheat a little bit. You actually want these flowers.
Go, Hewie. Go!
Yeah, he doesn't like these things. I don't like them either. And try to get rid of it. Oh, great, there's two of them. So as I mentioned, those things don't actually damage you. What they do is they explode and get the attention of stalkers in the area, and they also cause you to panic. So, but the way you get rid of them is you just close the door behind them and just hang out in the dark until they disappear. Fortunately, they're not very common, but they always appear in the worst possible place. Actually, this is perfect. Come here. Come here. No, Hewie. For once, I don't want you. Yes. Yes. Close the door. Close the door on them. Okay, perfect. Perfect. That is exactly what I wanted. I actually wanted to show you something in that room, but it's okay. There will be another opportunity.
Go! Go, Hewie.
I need a... Section of fence is broken. There is a hole.
Go, Hewie.
I need you to go into this hole.
Go, Hewie.
That's okay. Okay, we might actually have to find that place where we need the moth attractor. I think it was one of those doors that
Come
we
on.
Saw. I read that this game was actually supposed to get a remake for the PlayStation 3, but apparently that just never panned out. I have no idea why, because this is a great game. An empty flower vase. This picture has been ripped out and discarded. I'm no critic, but it doesn't seem that bad. Look at all these yuck! Look at all these moths. I'm not going there. Looks like they're attracted to those flowers. Can I hide under here? No. Actually catch me here this time, but...
My darling!
Whoops!
My
buddy.
My darling.
I'm not sure if he follows you here. I think this is one of the spots where he kind of gives up. Worst case, we can hide in this corner right here. Okay, those were my footsteps. The door is locked. Yes, it is. This is another puzzle that took me way too long to figure out the first time. So yeah, you drag things into place, that much is clear. That's how you drag them into place. So if I recall correctly, I didn't notice the second set of stairs, which was the problem. So yeah, you push this one in first. Actually, no, that wasn't it. This is how I screwed up the first time. That's okay, you can actually exit and re-enter and figure it out. And they're back into they're back where they need to be. Yeah, usually if you start seeing a lot of remakes in the market, that's because the market is doing badly, and people are afraid of taking risks. And eventually you run out of you kind of burn people out. Fine for now, because I can still get right here. I'm gonna push that one out and get behind it and push it out some more. It's funny because Debilitas is the only one that isn't actively trying to hurt you on purpose. Come on. This boy out of the way. The camera angle here in this game is usually good, but sometimes it just goes into a weird, flies off somewhere strange, and I don't understand why. Let's push this guy right here. Pretty thin, so she can get through there. I'm just kidding, that's not really that wide of a hole. Huey's outside freaking out. He doesn't understand why I left him. Unfortunately, I don't think he can get into combat unless you're in combat, so he'll just kind of hang out outside by himself. Can't remember the last time I did this puzzle. I think like somewhere in the beginning of August or something. My first playthrough was really long. I think it was like 12 hours. Mostly it was because I spent 3 hours running around the first part. And my second playthrough, the part that took me the longest, took me just, I think, half an hour. I mean, I'm running towards 2 hours right now, but that's... I'm pretty sure that's less than half the amount of time it took me to figure this out the first time. This is a PS2 game, I think, it's another game that I want to replay. It's Parasite Eve. I don't know why, but recently I feel I'm better with video games. I started off pretty badly, so... Let's find out what happens. Sound this game gives you. See, this is what I'm talking about, the camera. The camera usually is good. This part of the wall has been designed differently from the rest of the room. So yeah, what we need to do is we need to realign these guys. Time to go find Hewie. He's really sad. I don't know why, but that for some reason that assortment does not render very well.
Hewie. Come on.
Yeah, Hewie. I've done that before too. I've entered and exited the room, and after a couple of times, my German Shepherd wouldn't want to listen to me anymore. He just assumes I'm screwing around and I have no idea what I'm doing.
Hewie.
This happens a lot more than it should. Let's see, what do I have? Nothing. To go back outside. Come on, Hewie.
Come on.
can.
Hewie.
Oh yeah, that's right, I'm supposed to get the flowers. Okay.
Hewie.
Hewie, I need you.
Hewie.
What are you doing?
Come on.
He just wants to sit around.
Hewie.
Yeah, I know you want to go into that hole, but it's not time yet.
Go, Hewie.
Yeah, you have to discover it, and you have to trigger it before you. Exactly what you want. I don't know why I opened that. It's not where I need to be. You know, I haven't seen the Bilitas for a while.
Hewie.
I'm kind of concerned.
Come on.
Hewie.
Hewie.
No, you were going the right way.
Come on. Come on.
What are you doing over there?
Come on. Come on.
Flowers. These flowers look as if they have literally just been picked out of the ground. Can't imagine why. They are giving off a sweet nectar-like smell. I don't know why I'm not sure if those things are actually supposed to be moths, because I'm not sure. Because I don't know why you would be afraid of moths. They are the most harmless things ever. They're just night butterflies. They're actually really delicate. This is yet another part that killed me many times my first playthrough because I didn't take the cue from the game. Looks like a key or something is lying on the ground, but I can't reach it. Yeah, so that's the small hole that we have to get to. Like Hewie found something. Furniture is covered with freshly washed sheets. It's actually not good for the furniture. That actually ruins the finish on them. Unless they're sealed. Oh, yeah. This was. Oh, wow. This is unfair. I like the little details, like how the ribbon and the her skirts both move. There's a lot of little details in this game, or not really details, but just I would just say,
come on.
The level of, come on, are you serious?
Come on.
The level of quality is really good.
Come on.
He's not really fat, he's literally just a mountain of meat. He's a big boy.
Come on.
Boy, can you just get through this hole? Yeah, this is another reason. The black and tan German Shepherd just doesn't listen to you.
Come on. Come on.
Maybe I can just wait it out. Or screw it, I'll just go through the other side. Deal with this bookshelf problem. We'll notice that Fiona, one of Fiona's favorite methods of dealing with her enemies is throwing them off of high places. There's actually several very brutal deaths in this game. Again, I have no idea how to get up there. I think you can use Hewie to get that, but I'm not sure. Okay, no, this is Daniela's room. She has such a weird place for her room. good. You're here.
Hewie.
I need you.
Hewie.
Oh, now you don't... You found me, and now you don't want to listen to me.
Hewie.
Get in the
hole. Go, Hewie.
Yes, yes, that is the hole that I want you to go into.
Go, Hewie.
Good boy. You're set, right? Hewie's eyes glimmer through the thick shadow that surrounds him.
Okay.
Good, 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 good. Should let those moths out. Okay, and now we're gonna do this. And if you do not do this, as far as I know, you are very screwed. So yeah, you have to put this over here. I think this is as far as it goes. Because if you don't, then Debilitas sneaks up behind you. And it's impossible to escape, because Hewie's is going to be on the other side of a grate, and yeah, basically what happens is that Debilitas drops in down here with you, and you see how slowly Fiona climbs the ladder. She just starts pulling you down and just stomping you to death, and there's no way to escape. It's kind of a trap that this game sets for you, and I mean, whatever. I mean, there's no other doors that you get that you have to block like that, so I guess it's kind of a hint.
My darling.
Pretty fast. This hiding spot has screwed me over numerous times, but I'll give it another shot. Yeah, RE4 got a lot of attention. I don't understand how it managed to get out on the GameCube. That's what I don't understand. Hewie, where'd you come from?
Hewie!
a spot that doesn't work too well.
My darling.
The bed.
Good night.
I actually haven't played Resident Evil 4 yet. This is one of the games I definitely have to play, and I have several copies. I have it for PC, I have it for PS2, I believe. I think I have it for something else. I may have like a compilation copy for the PS4. I'm not sure if it came out for the PS4. I haven't played through a single Resident Evil game all the way through, but I really want to play that fourth one. What I'm planning to, actually what I can do is I was going to play Rule of Rose next, but I might just play Resident Evil 4 because I really need to get through that game. But I need to find my my composite cable. I stopped using it because it wasn't compatible with my capture card, as far as I could tell. And I don't really feel like paying $50 for an official composite cable. But the composite has a much higher, I can't remember if it's compound or composite, but the composite, one of those has a higher picture quality. The one thing I found funny about Resident Evil, especially the later games, is how the zombies, more so for Resident Evil 4, how all the enemies slowly came really slowly toward you and choreographed their attacks to make up for the fact that it's really hard to aim, free aim with a controller. You know what? I'm kind of screwed right now because I need to get upstairs. The pot is filled with what look like tendrils. Wait a second, this looks like human hair. There's actually a theory that the human hair is a... Oh, this? No, I'm playing this on a... No, I'm playing this on a PlayStation 2. I actually was stupid enough to find the physical copy of this. It's almost perfect. It's an almost perfect copy. Like, it gets stuck during the credits because of a scratch, but otherwise it works perfectly fine. At this stage, I kind of got the idea that I would just play through it once, make an ISO, and if I ever wanted to play through an emulator, I would just play through the ISO. But I can't make an ISO with this, so I'm gonna... Yeah, they're really expensive. That's why I'm waiting to see if there's a loose copy for just a disc. And I can just get a disc copy, like with no manual or case. But right now, yeah, they're like $300, $400. I have a copy of Kuon, and it went up by like over 100% in price in the past few months. I don't know why.
Where is he? Where is the old man? Where's he hiding?
she's like, is that it?
I won't let him touch her. Do you hear me, old man? The Azoth is mine.
Yeah, you fall to panic a lot easier on hard. On normal, she just kind of like got freaked and spooked by that and brushed it off. But here, you basically have to get equipment. Like right now, I got a bunch of equipments. I didn't get any equipments until the last part during my first run through. But I have an obsidian choker and Inquisitor earrings. Obsidian and Inquisitor. But I personally prefer the Jade Choker, because the Obsidian just keeps luminescence away, but this Choker lets you run a long time, and I feel like the enemies are actually run faster on hard, so this is very useful. With Alchemist Earrings, oh, by the way, thank you for the follow. I always appreciate that. Platinum Earrings lets you panic a lot less, which is also important. Personally, I prefer my fairy earrings that I accidentally crafted during the last few hours of the last game, and those made the game so much easier, because they basically, if you stand still long enough, you become invisible, and unless they bump right into you, they can't see you. And at that point, Ricardo was the stalker, and he has a gun. He's a very bad shot with it, but he has a gun. Go away. I really wish I had Hewie right now.
Hewie!
I don't know why that didn't work. I'm gonna try the bathtub again. That worked well last time, and it's the only hiding spot that's close right now. Get in.
Hewie!
Okay, well, you're gonna come in soon anyway, so it doesn't matter. I also want to play Clock Tower now. I wasn't really burning to play Clock Tower or Fatal Frame, but after this game and hearing the similarities of Clock Tower, I really want to try it out. Yeah, stick your head in the toilet. Maybe end in there. What I really wanted to do is I went through my collection, and I found that I have Rule of Rose, Haunting Ground, and Kuon, and it seems like Kuon and Rule of Rose seem to be in good shape. This one seems to be in the worst shape. I don't even know how it got scratched. I'm hoping I didn't do it, because it was a second-hand copy, but I hope I didn't do it, because I'm usually careful with my games. He's getting antsy. checking the toilet. Maybe I'm hiding in there. I am pretty small. I like how this hiding spot is completely useless because he's guaranteed to open it every single time. I hope Hewie doesn't attack me. This game trolls you a lot. Anyway, I was thinking about getting those three games. I've already played Gulon. I haven't migrated all the playthroughs from my personal channel over to my streaming channel on YouTube, but I'm sure you can find them. You can find them somewhere in the repository for my Twitch channel if you really want to see them. Kuon, I'd say, is a more compact, more polished game. I liked it. The ending didn't make 100% sense to me, but it was fun. The mini game I can't remember what it was called. It's basically some weird form of mahjong, but it's fun, but the computer cheats. It's really hard to win. The mini game on this the mini game here is a lot more I guess fair. Lunar refractor. It's okay. All right. I unfortunately will have to leave Hewie again if I go in this direction, but I don't have much of a choice. Because that dumbass is following me around. I might be ending the stream soon, by the way. I have to meet with someone for something.
Hewie.
Normally I stream Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 7:30 to whenever I feel like. No puppets? Oh, the puppets room. Yeah, yeah, that's a fun one. Yeah, what's even funnier is that those puppets are all nailed, stapled and riveted with rusty iron nails. And if you screw up the puzzle in that room, that's exactly what happens to you. Oh, by the way, if you hate puppet rooms, you're probably gonna hate this room too. Sorry, ma'am. Forgot to tell you.
Hewie.
I'm not laughing at you, by the way. I was really, really scared of clowns when I was little.
Go, Hewie.
I was kind of afraid of everything.
Hewie.
Come on.
Come
I was
on.
Kind of afraid of everything, but then I met this guy. Who was a clown. I don't know if it was a fit or something, but this, like, despite the fact that I was crying, he just acted really cool and really calm, and he gave me this really silly ring. I think it was just this metallic like a drama type of sad face, like the tragedy comedy faces.
Go, Hewie.
Can you get that?
Go, Hewie.
It was a comedy face. Yeah, I think you have to get the right angle.
Go, Hewie. Go, Hewie.
Anyway, he gave me the ring, and I was still freaked out, but it yes, finally. So I know how to get that thing. There's another one that I'm not sure how to, that is in the entrance to the kitchen. It's the entrance to the kitchen or the dining hall. I can't remember which one, but it's also on the high point, and I don't know how to get it. I will get you in a moment. Just have to solve this stupid puzzle first. I felt a lot better about clowns after that interaction. I think I lost the ring, or it broke and my parents threw it away. I kind of wish I still had it. It was really cheap. I think it was made of aluminum, and it was the same quality of something that you would get from a vending machine. But I still appreciated how nice he was. Can obtain no weapons. The only thing she can do is she can get different types of earrings, chokers, and boots. There are actually a pair of boots that she can acquire that can cause catastrophic damage. Oh yeah, that's right, this cutscene. I swear there are voices coming from the hole. Search the hole. So if you have fears, I would turn away right now. Fears of the unknown. Or getting grabbed. Spoiler alert. There would have been an easier way to give her that. That is the last time I put my hands in there. You shouldn't have done it the first time. Damn that Ricardo. He has sealed off the main gate. But not to worry, there is another less known way out of the castle. An old mansion lies beyond the Belly Castle. Freedom to the outside lies through that mansion. I'm writing down directions for getting to the mansion below. On the first floor of the tower that lies on the other side of the suspension bridge, there are two round contraptions. These are known as the lunar panels. Use the lunar panels to shine light on the wall in the back room. Doing so will open the way to the chapel. There you should take the goddess key. Beam the light out of the second floor of the music window, then adjust the three lunar panels to proceed forward. Fiona, please understand that my only desire is to free you from this wretched tomb of a castle. Lorenzo. He's a fucking liar, but... yeah, he helps you. Oh, yeah, I think the cowgirl, I'm trying to play as vanilla as possible. I have the,
Hewie.
I have the saucy, costume that she has, and I also have the cowgirl costume. As well as the two normal ones, the vanilla one that I'm wearing now, and the surgical gown. I can't remember how to get to the music room. Let me think. Okay, first off, Hewie, get your ass over here, first off.
Come on.
Yeah, I think the cowgirl costume does have a gun. We're not doing that. Not right now.
Come on!
Are you hurt? I feel every time I run into you. I think the best opening door animation of the Stalkers that I've seen is by Ricardo, where he opens the door with his hand, and then he kicks the door open, and then he turns around and closes the door half the time. I think this game makes the most sense with people like, Daniela as the enemy, because she's so robotic and spastic and weird and removed from anything remotely resembling a human being that, that she fits in perfectly in here. I'm just running around like an idiot because I can't remember what. Oh, great.
Come
there's
on.
Two of them.
Come on.
Because I can't recall what I'm supposed to do. I know where I'm supposed to go, I just don't know how to get there.
Come on.
It took me half an hour to get through that last sequence of the game. Half an hour. Because first off, you're supposed to, what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to first I'm gonna save. Because I've been up and about for a while. I don't want to lose like an hour worth of gameplay. First off, the first door that you come across is jammed, and normally, okay, you can kick the door open, right? Well, apparently that doesn't work. You have to get Hewie to knock it open. I didn't even know you could do that. And then you constantly have to do that little kneeling maneuver, like whenever the castle shakes, you kneel, and then it rumbles, and then you get up. And it doesn't affect the guy who's on fire, but it does affect you. There was a point where I didn't even bother kneeling anymore. I just took the hit, took some of my lavender, because I had a ton of lavender on me, and just kept going. And then you had to push that pillar off of you. It was less than fun.
Hewie.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, I have to go through this room again. With the needle shooting eyeballs. You might be afraid of getting a needle in your eye, but you're not afraid of, you wouldn't think to be afraid of having an eye put a needle in you. That's something that this game brings you. Alright, so... Where's that curved area where it leads into the, Okay, first off, where's Fiona's bedroom? Setting yourself, it's okay. There's nothing to find here. Come on.
Hewie.
Stand next to the door and try to get your
attention.
Come on. Okay, cool. Cool, got your attention. Logically, all I need to do is I need to get to the, where am I right now? Logically, all I need to do is get to the, to get to the music room, which is on the second floor. That's Daniela's room.
Hewie.
This is the first one. Okay, I remember. I'm an idiot, I remember.
Hewie.
Come on. There's actually a completely different area where I didn't notice the first time around.
Mm-hmm.
I have this habit of not finishing my thoughts because I keep getting distracted by what's going on in the game.
Hewie.
But what I intended to say earlier was, normally I stream every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Somebody's messaging me. Okay. So I'm actually gonna cut it right now because I have to go. So Friday, Saturday, Sunday, usually around 7:30, I stream until I get tired. So it's gonna, usually on Friday it's going to be about 2 hours. Saturday, Sunday, it's usually considerably longer, usually 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, whatever I feel like. I think I'm gonna keep playing, usually after I finish playing a new game that's that takes a considerable amount of concentration. Usually I'll take a break, but seeing as that I'm fairly comfortable with the controls of this game, I'm going to I'm probably just going to keep playing this for a while and see how far I can get into the hard version before it beats me up and locks me out. Also, I'll feel a lot better if the CD is still the DVD is still functional. I think it's good, but I really shouldn't push it too hard. It's had a hard life. It's not that badly scratched up, but there's one or two scratches. Well, now there's only one scratch that was pretty bad, but I buffed out most of the rest. Next time I'll see you is probably going to be Friday. I don't have any plans for the weekend, so it'll probably just stream on Friday, Saturday, Sunday as usual, 7:30. And it's going to be haunting ground unless I change my mind. If I do change my mind, it's going to be something like, I'm probably going to be playing something like Deus Ex or Killing Floor. Although I'm kind of taking a break from Killing Floor and Company of Heroes 2, so I'm not streaming that as much anymore. I want to finish up Bioshock, the original Bioshock, not the remastered version, the glitchy, messed up version, which is also fun to play for various reasons. And then I guess we'll move on to Rule of Rose. And Rule of Rose is apparently a combination of what Kuon and what Haunting Ground is. So hopefully we'll be ready. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.